Previously on Factions.
There's people in our base, bro.
Okay, that is the worst news we could hear right now.
He's dead. He's so. Yes! Give me that kill! Yes! Give us that kill, baby!
18, 7, 6, bam! That's another one!
Yeah,
oh, he's down!
There we go.
Give us that kill, baby! You mess with Pandemic's base, we drop the entire team! Hey, what's up, guys? TheCampingRusher here. Welcome back to Factions, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you so much for tuning into this show every single day. Starting off today's episode with the entire crew, Napkin, Wild, and Mitch. How are you, boys?
Good.
Good. Good. And? Napkin, that's your cue.
Oh. Alright.
You forgot how you're doing today, didn't you, dude? God dang it, dude! Come on! No, Nap's focused on some stuff right now with the server, and apparently he's got an alarm to... There, that was the alarm to remind you how you're doing today, Napkin, right there.
Yeah, there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, today is a big day. Today is the day that we announce one of the brand new updates on the Archon. I'm going to be explaining and talking about it with Curtis in just like literally 1 minute here. But I just wanted to start off this episode saying how you do. And I know last episode was crazy with us getting raided and everything. We'll go into that more later on in today's episode. To start off though, Daily Factions Comment Day coming in from Adrian Ruiz. I'd like to see Rusher try and go one full ep without jelly legs and try not to die of fall damage at some point. Also, I love the new previously on Factions, by the way. And the reason I chose this, yes, that would be a cool idea for me to try and live. I probably would not have a chance. But Mitch, if you didn't know, in yesterday's previously on Factions, Grape, who does the previously on Factions edits for me, he put your voice where you did it in the episode, I think it was two episodes back. I made you try it out. And he put you as the guy who did previously on Factions.
Oh,
and,
that's hilarious.
Oh, dude, it was hilarious, but I'm not saying in a bad way. You sounded epic, dude. Like, it sounded exactly how other people, like, I used to watch 90210. I brought this up before. Napkin and I both love that show. And,
Do you Napkin?
Napkin hates that show.
It's the stupidest show I've ever laid eyes on. I think I've watched like 5 minutes of it.
Yeah, okay. Well, I watched the whole season. And every episode, they switch out, right? One of the characters who does it. And Mitch sounded like one of the manly guys in the show.
Ooh,
who's just
man,
like, yeah,
man.
Previously on... I don't know. It sounded really cool, really good. And Mitch, I wanted to say, no backwards compliment or, you know, reverse psychology... You did a good job.
That's it. All right. Thanks, dude.
You're welcome.
I was expecting something else.
No, that's it. I'm nothing else, dude. You did a great job at that one thing, and I'm very proud of you. So,
thanks, dude.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will leave it there. We are going to, like I said, jump into a call with Curtis and talk to you guys about the brand new update here on the Archon. One of many updates to come. And just a heads up, I'll probably forget to mention this. I got another big thing to announce coming this weekend in tomorrow's episode, so make sure you tune in. Other than that, thanks for being here. Relax, sit back, grab some popcorn, and enjoy today's show. And congratulations to Cedar Beans for being the first ever person on the Archon to purchase a crate key drop from the shop.thearchon.net. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to tell you about this update. Curtis, how you doing today, buddy?
I'm doing pretty good, man. How about you?
I'm doing very good. I gotta broadcast this right now in chat. What's his name again? Let me see this. Let me see what his name was.
Cedar Beans.
Cedar Beans. Congrats on being the first ever person on the Archon to buy a drop. Let's put that live to the entire server so they can get hyped up. We have just released the brand new edition of the Archon. So, what is this? How does it work? Curtis is in the call. We're going to demonstrate. So, what it is basically, and Curtis can refine what I say here, is a EULA-friendly way to keep the crate keys alive. So, instead of buying a crate key from the shop and giving yourself an advantage, now you buy a crate key and it turns it into an event that everyone can be involved in. So how it works is you go to shop.thearchon.net. There's the same prices. A normal crate key is $249. A normal crate key drop is $249. They're not crate keys anymore. Crate key drop. Unique is $349. Golden $449. And ultimate is $549. And once you buy these things, you get a beacon. a brewing stand. I mean, sorry about that. See, Kurt, that's why you're here. You're here to correct me on stuff like that. A brewing stand is what you get. So I'm going to go to the BioCraft right now, grab a few of these in my inventory so I can give you that visual effect. Because I know me, I am a visual learner. I'm not good at listening to things. I need to see it, and then I can fully understand it. Cedar Beans has just called in his ultimate crate key supply drop. So that means somewhere in a war zone, in spawn, in Warp Nether or Warp End, he is calling this thing in right now, and anyone can grab it. But the thing is, he could be anywhere. Well, he can't be anywhere. He can only be in a war zone. People are looking for him right now, dude. They want to steal that thing, eh?
He got killed?
He got killed! No, did he grab it, you think?
I don't know.
I don't know either. And ladies and gentlemen, that is why it's EULA compliant. And so how it works, obviously, there's a good chance you can get it, right? You can get this thing. You know where it is. But you got to play it smart. And this guy was the first ever guy to do it. Oh, no way he got killed. I feel so bad for him, man. I hope he actually got it. I just added it to my inventory, so it's just taking a couple minutes to load, and then I'll have one of each supply drop, and I'm going to demonstrate how they work and smarter strategies so you can, hopefully win it, though. So here it is. The Camping Rusher just said has purchased the ultimate crate key drop, the unique, the normal, the golden. It all comes up here when you purchase it. So that's a little rough. See, now everybody knows. Everyone's saying abuse, too. this is for demonstration purposes, ladies and gentlemen. But everyone knows, right, that I have these things now. So this is what you get. You get it in your inventory. Make sure you have enough space in your inventory, right, Curtis? So do you have to be online when you buy these things, or how does it work?
Yeah, you have to be online, and you have to have space in your inventory.
Okay, so make sure you have space, and make sure you are online. So if you're going to buy a bunch of them, make sure you've got the correct inventory space. So now I've got these, all right? I've got 4 beacons, and they are labeled correctly. Now, everyone, so you see how everyone's watching me? You know, with me, I got the red name, so it's a little bit more target. Everyone is following me because they know they have a chance at these things. But remember, it's any war zone. You cannot place these outside of a war zone. This is a world event. Everybody is involved, and everyone has a chance to get these things. That's what makes it EULA compliant. Okay, dude, I've got 3 of my crate keys here. I don't have the normal one. I'm going to put it... I'm going into spawn war zone right now, dude. I'm booking it. Dude.
Oh, my God. I'm gonna...
Does anyone see me? I don't think anyone sees me. I don't think anyone sees me.
All right, be quick.
I'm doing it. I'm going to do the ultimate crate key supply drop. Let me go slash spawn quickly, though. Slash spawn. I'm going to slash back in just a second just to show you what's going on. So right over here, ultimate crate key. I have 7 of these right now, all right? Keep that in mind. Slash back to where I was.
Someone's here.
Oh, crap, dude. Oh, crap. I got to place this thing. Ultimate crate key. I'm still in the war zone right over here, right?
Yeah.
All right, I placed it. The camper rusher called
two.
In.
There's 2.
Oh, there's 2. They're waiting for me. Where's the chest?
There, behind you. He's got it.
He got it from me! He got it, Kurt! No! God dang it, he beat me! He took my ultimate crate key! No! And that, ladies and gentlemen, is exactly why this thing is EULA compliant, man. Oh, that is depressing. That is depressing. Now, keep in mind, it does work in the Nether or End, okay? So that guy, I called in the drop. I'm going to do another demonstration here where I'm safe so I can show you guys. I'm honestly, okay, I want to get out of this fight. I'm not here to fight right now, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here to demonstrate. Back up a second. Give me a second to get out of here. I'll sprint out. But I'm going to demonstrate. I'm going to get away from these guys. And then I will... So he got my crate key. I called it in. That was my chest. But once it is down, anyone can loot that chest. And that Eye of Ender, I thought I had it there. If I right-click that Eye of Ender, it gives you the crate key. And then you go spin the crate key at spawn like you normally would. Shout out to 7x4. Just purchased an ultimate crate key drop. Big ups to you, man. Thank you so much. All right. I'm swinging it around now back to the war zone. I'm going to... Dude, god dang it, man. How did that happen, Kurt? I'm sort of BH, you know, a little butthurt, but it's just, it's part of the game, man. It's part of the game. It's part of how it's going to work. All right, slash F map. I'm still in the war zone over here. Okay, so we got so this is the war zone. This still counts. It's all around spawn. It's all around the end, and it's all around the Nether, okay? Like the Nether spawn, end spawn, and normal spawn. That is where you can place these. You can't place anywhere else. All right, unique crate key coming in now. Camera Rusher is called in a supply crate key drop. Everybody knows it tells them it'll land in 5 seconds, so it gives them some time. Then it spawns somewhere near me. I can't. There it is. There it is. There it is. I go in here, loot it, got it, right click it, boom. I now have a unique crate key. And that is exactly how this thing works, ladies and gentlemen. I can do. Am I safe still? I'm safe. So it does spawn semi near this area. It is random, so you got to look around for it. You could see when I called it with Shlomon there, I didn't really know where it was at. Yeah, right here, right here. Found it. And golden crate key. Remember, if you die with this thing in your inventory, you don't get the key. You have to right click it, and now you have it. You can see activated golden crate key. Now if I go back to slash spawn, I can look in here. I know I didn't show you the number I have, but I now have 52 golden keys rather than 51. I had 51 before this. And then same here with the unique crate key. Everyone's going pretty hype in chat. Hip, hip. They're all getting fired up. Oh, this is nuts, man. This is absolutely nuts. So that's how it works. I mean, you guys saw there. I got 3 crate keys. And 2 of them I got and 1 of them I didn't. So you gotta make sure you've got a good strategy for getting these things, because that's what makes it EULA compliant. Everybody has a chance, but you can do strategies and hopefully find a way to get your key, but it's a battle. It's an all-out battle, and sometimes your enemies are gonna get the key. And everyone sees it in chat, right? So when you call it in, it gives a 5-second warning to you and to everybody on the server that a supply crate key drop is about to get called in. And obviously people are gonna be hunting for you as soon as they see that you've purchased one of these things. So that's it, dude. Curtis, very happy to announce this. This is very exciting. You can get any of the keys, normal, unique, ultimate, and golden, on any of the servers through the new supply drops. So for now, that is where we're at. Oh, Cedar Beans just bought another one, dude. Hype to this guy. Thank you so much, man, for purchasing. I hope he gets it this time, man. I hope he gets it. And oh my god, this guy just won an IG spawner already. Wait, II Solar, did he purchase one or did he steal it?
Yeah, he purchased one.
The first one this guy purchases, he pulls off an IG spawner from the ultimate crate key, dude. This is so good to see again. We haven't seen this in chat, like the crate key stuff in chat, since EULA stuff came out. And this is so, I don't know, it's really exciting for me to have this. So, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you jump on pvp.thearchon.net. Crate keys have always been a huge part of our economy and the Archon, and now we've got a way to keep it going. So thank you for your financial support. Head over to shop.thearchon.net. Pick one up right now. Try it out. It's almost like, I know it's riskier and you know, all that, but it is more, it's almost more fun, dude. Like, you gotta buy the key, you gotta buy the drop, then you gotta get the key, and then you gotta win something decent, dude. I don't know, it's pretty fun, pretty risky, a good time, and I don't know, anything else, Kurt? Is that all for now?
That's it, bro.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the support, and there is our new thing, the Crate Key Supply Drop. Wow, am I excited to show you guys that. So I got Mitch and Wild back here now. Wild, Mitch, I know you guys are kind of excited to see, because you guys haven't used these yet, have you?
No.
Okay, so yeah. We'll do some stuff with the supply drops. We'll do one more supply drop near the end of the video. It is pretty late, so what I want to do, like maybe even tomorrow or something, maybe we'll go hunting for people doing supply drops, like midday when everyone's online, because right now we're filming pretty late, as we have been doing the last few days, but I don't know. Either way, it's time to get some info on yesterday's raid. So, according to FTop, we are at 879 million. 48 hours ago, we were at 1.489 million, something like that. So, we are down about 600 mil from yesterday. We lost a lot of stuff. And we are going to show you what went down. And, Wild, you know a decent amount, don't you?
I know a couple things.
You know a couple things. So I'll be asking away, and Mitch wasn't here last night. So Mitch, yeah, we got raided at like 4 a.m. Eastern, dude. So we...
Oh, it's terrible.
Yeah, we tried to fight our way. We got like 8 kills, 8 or 9 kills, killed almost everyone in that base, but they took every single IG before we could do anything. So here are the sand walls that were destroyed. Everything else has been patched. So every wall was taken out, right, Wild? All the walls, like, there wasn't any crazy trick to this one. They went through every wall, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So this as many walls they went through. Like, this person knows what's going on. It wasn't some weird inside or anything. It was a straight cannon raid. And basically what we got is out here, I believe-ish, in this area. I'm trying to locate the cannon box so I can show you this thing. Never mind, Wild had a TP to the cannon box. So where am I at right now? I'm just trying to kind of grasp where I'm at. So slash ascend puts me here. So this is the box. That's the base. That is a different box. And that's the base right there. So if I slash descend again, I can go back underneath to Wild. And ladies and gentlemen, the bad news. If I go F map right now, it's claimed. Who's this claimed by? It's claimed by Decline, correct? But they haven't had this claim the entire time, right, Wild?
No.
It's a recent claim. So what does that mean? That means we have no idea who took all of our stuff. I mean, I'm guessing, like, I know Ethan was there, and there was a bunch of dudes there, right? We got a bunch of kills. All those guys we were fighting yesterday, I think it was Vextra Faction, they got some of the stuff, but I don't know how long it had been raided before they got in and before we got online. And according to FTop, there has not been any crazy adjustments. Starfall and Anonymous are still around 300, Supremacy 175, Vextra's only at 65. $600 million is missing. And we have not found out which faction has it, and it doesn't look like they are going to show that they have it. So right now, this is the remains. This is the cannon, or what is left of the cannon, that was used to raid our base and take around 100 iron golem spawners from our base. We don't know. Again, it was not Decline who raided us. They have the claim now, but that is because the people who were here either didn't even claim their cannon, or they unclaimed because they wanted to be left anonymous. And that kind of sucks, man. Like, I want closure, you know what I mean? Like, we lost, right? We lost the battle, we got raided, we lost a bunch of money, but it's nice to have some closure and have some sort of way to release our anger, to get back, to try and avenge our mistake and to avenge our loss. But right now, this is all the evidence we've got. And Mitch, you are known to be a detective in this series. What is your heart leaning towards right now, dude?
Yeah, dude, I don't know. I think it's just a faction that came on, raided us, and then logged off.
Logged off. Took all the stuff, too.
Never to be seen again.
Never to be seen again. And that's the issue here, ladies and gentlemen. So this is what we got. I mean, we're going to obviously keep with all our hearts, keep investigating this thing and try and figure out who is involved, who is here. Does anyone have information? Because we need to find out where $600 million just magically disappeared to. Because right now, according to FTop, even though Justified is our ally, they are only $250 million away right now. And that seems like a lot, but we were about, $900 million, $800 million in front of everybody before. So tables have turned, things are a bit more risky, and there's still just under 2 weeks left in this season. So there is lots of room for error, raids, etc. And I wish we had more info for you, but this is all we got. Mitch, some good news. We are going to be bringing back something we haven't done in a long time. And what I want to ask you today, Mitch, is today, or yesterday, I guess, we lost, again, the richest part of our base we've been living in for, 35-ish days, 36-ish days since the start of this season. We just lost the richest part of that base, and it's a huge portion of that base, so it deserves a proper goodbye. And not only that, Grazer and his guy raided Napkin's personal base that I lived in with Napkin, and you did too, technically, for the first 2 or 3 weeks. That was raided a while ago, but we haven't gotten to it. Mitch, I'd like you to take a speech and do a little bit of a 2-for-1 goodbye to these two bases right now in front of everybody. Is that all right?
Yeah, I got it, man.
All right, take the floor, dude. Cue the music.
At the beginning of the season, we started from rags. We worked our ways to riches, and now we're back to rags. Sail on, sailor. Sail on, sailor.
Oh, it gets me every time, man. Okay. Okay. You always know the right thing to say, man, and that's why I love you. That's why this show loves you, man. Thank you. Thank you for that. Wild, you okay? Tissue?
He's He's gone.
He's taking a walk. He's gone. He had to take a walk.
That one touched him personally.
Oh, I loved how you said sail on sailor twice. I love that. Oh my god, he actually did leave, dude. Wild left. He couldn't handle it, man.
He's like, oh man.
Wild, are you okay? You're back now. Are you crying?
Yeah, dude, I just was looking for a pump-up speech, coach.
Yeah, no worries there, coach. All right, well, you called me coach. Okay.
Coach Taylor,
all right.
Coach Taylor.
Thank you, Mitch. I appreciate that. I mean, something I've always said is you keep a full heart and you can't lose, right? And that is what we need to do going into the rest of this season. All right, so a couple things left today. Today has been kind of all over the place, emotions, the unknown mystery, but one thing I do know is there is a double XP booster going on right now, and I want to shout out the guy, so give me a second. I think it just started. It was I think it's got about 45 minutes left on it, and guess who it is? Our boy Axel Rob. I just missed it there, but Axel Rob activated a 2x XP booster. So we actually haven't done a... Oh, here it is right here. Double XP multiplier, 1 hour. There's 45 minutes left in this thing. So really cool, man. Like, thanks to everybody who's been purchasing the boosters and supporting the Archon financially and just supporting by playing and watching the show. Just big ups to you guys. Really appreciate it, man. So with that being said, gentlemen, the reason I bring this up is because I've got 25 levels. We have barely been doing enchant stuff recently, which, you know, isn't bad. That just means we've got the necessary enchants that we need. But I figured with double XP activated is a good excuse. I don't know if you guys got XP bottles in your e-chest or anything, but I've got about 13 XP stacks of XP bottles that I can use up right now. So I am going to do some of this, and we're going to spin some enchants and see if we can make some more money here, or even tack it on to some of our new armor. Level 45, if you guys could tell, I think I used, what, 2 stacks of XP there? So obviously double XP works very well right now. Do you guys have enough XP, or am I spinning solo right now?
No, I got enough.
Oh, Mitch is ready. Mitch is ready to spin. He loves these luck games, man, the crate key. Mitch, how happy are you about the supply drops being back now that we can spin crate keys again?
Oh, dude, I am ecstatic.
Mitch is like that one commercial. That's my forte, dude. This is Mitch's forte,
my
man.
Forte.
All right, here we go. Spin once. Jump tier 3. Reborn 3. All right. I'll take it.
I got Beast 3.
Beast? What? That's pretty good, man. All right. Yeah, man. Beast 3. I'd put that in top 4 things you can spin from tier 3. Not bad at all. And oh,
not
my God.
Really? Is it that good?
Oh, it's pretty good, dude. It's pretty good. I don't think I have ever spun a Beast 3 from just spinning. Yeah, double XP is hype, dude. This is a good call, boys. I'm already almost back up to level 45. And I'm back up to level 45. I'm not even going to spin this time. Boom. Bass Pro 3. Shout out to Napkin for adding Bass Pro 3. What'd you get, Mitch?
Yeah, I got Replenish 3.
I don't believe you. Did you actually?
Yeah.
What? Dude, I can't. I don't even know what to say anymore. Am I supposed to get super excited, or do I just roll with it? Like, dude, maybe 2 times I've spanned Replenish 3 in my lifetime. Wild and I actually did a double spin one time. I freaked out, man. Like, I got up out of my chair. I'm like, Mom, get the camera. I got Replenish 3, and then you do it. And I'm, you know, obviously I'm happy. Like, woo, you just made yourself 300 grand. But wow, are you good at this stuff, which is something that is impossible to be good at. So I don't even understand, man. Thunderous 3 is my next one. Either way, GG, Mitch. This double XP thing is insane. Oh, my God.
You hold one more?
Yeah, keep going. Shout out to Axel Rob, for doing this, man, for this network booster, even though he's my enemy and I slightly dislike him most of the time. He's going up in my books right now.
I got Tipsy 3.
Tipsy 3, yay! Not another not too bad one. I got Thunderous 3, which is like, I'd say around that level. Tipsy 3 is pretty good. Not great, but it's nice to have on your god set, in my opinion. One more, this will be my last tier 3 spin, ladies and gentlemen. And then I want to show Mitch the new supply drops. And Wild, I guess, too. And tier 3! I got my... What did I say? I just spammed Beast 3 as well, dude. Nice, man!
Nice, dude.
We just got half a god set.
I got Vanish 3.
Vanish 3, okay. That one's not as good. But, hey, not terrible either. It could be a lot worse. Alright, I will save the rest of those. Well, I might as well use them. But I won't have enough to get to 45 again. With that being said, gentlemen, I'm going to give each of us one ultimate crate key drop. and we are going to hopefully get them and not get them stolen by someone like Shlomon. That happened to me earlier today. One more thing I should point out, I did get up back up to level 42, and we did four tier 3 spins. I think that's the most I've ever done in one session. The power of double XP, man. Double XP booster. Again, big shout out to Axel Rob. All right, so we didn't do it earlier, but I let you guys know. Warp Nether, Warp End, any type of war zone, you can spin these crate keys in. Or not saying spin. You can do the supply drops in, okay? So, Mitch and Wild, you guys each now have an ultimate crate key supply drop, right?
Yep.
Okay, so I am going to go to slash, I guess we'll go to slash, what, you guys want to do Warp End? Is anyone there yet?
Yeah, I'm here. Nobody's here.
No one's here? Okay, let's do Warp End then. I think, like, obviously once this video comes out, it'll be a little tougher, I think, because there's going to be, who knows what they'll be called, but, you know, some, they'll be dubbed a name, I bet, like Hunters or Scavengers or something, that just go around and search for people doing this, dude. So run out as far as we can, where we're, I think, as soon as this cool looking floor disappears, that's it. Let's stop right here, boys. I think we're pretty safe here. All right, so all you do, Mitch, you go first, Mitch. So
place
all
right, boys.
All right, place it straight down.
Place it straight down.
Here we go, boys.
Now it says in chat, Mr. Mitch called in ultimate, so did Wild. Everyone knows, so and boom, behind you, Wild. Yours is behind you. Oh, can I grab it?
I got it.
Awesome.
Yeah, and then Mitch, your chest is spawned somewhere.
It's right there.
It's right here. We've added a firework, and I took your key.
Are you serious?
Yo, Mitch, go back in the chest. I gave it back to you, bro.
That's awesome.
There you go.
So can that be opened by anybody or just people in your faction?
Anybody. And it is a world event, which makes it you look compliant,
robbed.
Dude. Okay, here we go. Here's mine, boys. You want to race for mine? Good luck, gentlemen. Where is it? Oh, no!
Got it.
God!
I stole the pickaxe.
Yeah, I put my pick in there by accident, I think, too. I don't know, like, in my opinion, obviously a little bit riskier. Like, if you do it right, you're gonna be able to get this thing if you're smart about it. There's always a chance, though, you won't. But I feel like this is just, like, it's so fun, man. I don't know, like, the odds are high, and you gotta have a good time with it. I don't know, it's fun, it's on edge, and it's a little bit more difficult, which makes it more enjoyable. So then all you do, guys, is you right-click it, and then it would go into your crate key bank, which is, of course, that spawn, and you just spin the crate key as per usual. You know what I mean?
Awesome.
Yeah, I know what you mean, dude.
Awesome. All right, well, with that, guys, let's spin our ultimate crate key that we just earned. Here we go. It's been a while. I think the last one I spent, I won 7 IG spawners. Like, I won the jackpot. Warlord kit! And I just dropped everything. I wasn't ready for that. I just dropped it all. Either way, I got a Warlord kit for you boys. I'll take that.
I got a cow spawner.
Wild got a cow spawner.
Oh, I got a cow spawner. That's
and
cow.
Mitch got a cow. Dang it, dude. Your debut back and you got a cow spawner, man. Oh,
that is
this
weird.
May be the first time, ladies and gentlemen, that your boy Brayden won the crate key. Like, I don't know, the little crate key challenge we have going on. But with that being said, ladies and gents, that'll wrap up today's episode of Faction. If you did enjoy, touch that like button, join the rush by subscribing. Make sure to jump on pvp.thearchon.net. This is live on all servers. You can get any of the crate key supply drops right now. Shop.thearchon.net. Shout out to the recent 5 donators: Jeremy, Zane Malo, BFB Sandman, Max Batson 10, XX Awesome XD, all purchasing supply drops. Thank you so much. We really do appreciate it. Hope you guys all have a beautiful day. We'll talk to you all soon. Goodbye.